We are not medical professionals. We inform students presenting current research on miscarriages. For the content, you may not want to watch this video alone. We recommend you watch this video with a trusted individual. Miscarriages are a common occurrence that result in a spontaneous loss of an embryo. Sometimes one may have an increased risk of miscarriages due to alcohol consumption, smoking, drug usage, environmental factors, medications, or infections. Along the way, during development, things can go wrong, and it's not your fault. For example, miscarriages can happen because of chromosomal abnormalities, ectopic pregnancy, and pre-existing or developed medical conditions. Did you know the most common causes of miscarriages are chromosomal abnormalities? Now you must be wondering what chromosomal abnormalities are and why 50 to 70% of women experience them. So chromosomes contain genetic information in the form of genes. Different chromosomes have different genes, which makes us unique from one another. We all have 46 chromosomes. The fetus gets 23 from its mother and 23 from its father. During this process, sometimes the fetus can end up with duplicated chromosomes that incorrectly repeat the same genes, deletion of genes that are vital for survival, or chromosomes with genes switched in the wrong order. Any of these mutations could result in a miscarriage. Another common cause of miscarriage is ectopic pregnancies. Ectopic pregnancies are common to 6 to 16% of women that have miscarriages. During an ectopic pregnancy, the fertilized egg implants itself in the fallopian tube. Unfortunately, there aren't any treatments to transfer the fertilized egg from the fallopian tube into the uterus. Certain medical conditions can lead to miscarriages. Something to keep in mind is that not all medical conditions lead to miscarriages, and not all miscarriages happen because of pre-existing medical conditions. Keeping that in mind, a common medical condition women have is polycystic ovary syndrome, also known as PCOS. PCOS is a hormonal condition in which women can have irregular or prolonged menstrual period, failing to regularly release eggs. They're also known to have higher androgen levels, which are a group of male hormones. The imbalance in hormones and high levels of androgen can prevent the release of an egg, resulting in less opportunities to fertilize eggs. If one is pregnant, the imbalance in hormones can lead to miscarriage due to insufficient growth of the uterine lining or due to the lack of estrogen because of the androgen hormone. Symptoms experienced during a miscarriage are subjective, as every female will have a different experience. Some miscarriages will be more or less painful than others. However, most women have reported cramping, back or abdominal pain, spotting, and passing clot-like substances. Treatment options vary per individual, as every case is different. For example, some may expel the embryonic tissue naturally, while others can take medications prescribed by their doctor. In other cases, a dilation and curated, also known as DNC, will be performed, in which the cervix is dilated 6 to 9 millimeters and the embryonic tissue will be removed. Experiencing miscarriages are common to women everywhere. Miscarriages and the topic of miscarriages should not be stereotyped or stigmatized. Miscarriages can take a huge toll on not only the female that experiences it, but on her friends or family involved. If you have had a miscarriage in the past, it does not mean you cannot get pregnant in the future. But not all cases are the same. For more information, contact your family doctor or specialist to discuss your case. To join the road to recovery, there are many resources available for you and your family. For example, there are hotlines and organizations such as Call Pregnancy, Birth, and Baby, SANS, Planned Parenthood, and Compassionate Friends of Canada, as well as many more. Although we have named a limited list of hotlines, there are other potential emotional outlets, such as Pregnancy and Infant Loss Awareness Day, as well as sharing your grief with trusted individuals. This video was created by informed students to present current peer-reviewed research for educational purposes. Once again, we are not medical professionals. Since every pregnancy and miscarriage is different, please consult with your physician for further information.